Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial course. In this session, we will work with the having clause in SQL. So the having clause is used in conjunction with the group by statement to impose certain conditions on the groups which are to be displayed. So the having clause was added to SQL because the where keyword could not be used with aggregate functions. For example, over here we have four departments A, B, C and D. And we also have the corresponding average salary of the employees belonging to each department. Now, let's say we wanted to see only those departments where the average salary is greater than $100,000. So this is where having clause can be used to impose the condition and get only those departments where the average salary is greater than $100,000. And this is the syntax for the having clause. Here, you need to keep in mind that the having clause must follow the group by clause and must also precede the ORD by clause if used. So let's go to SQL server and implement the having clause. So we'll group this table with respect to the department column and then use the having clause to display only those departments where the average salary is greater than $100,000. So let me go ahead and write the syntax for that. I will type in the select keyword and then list down all of the columns which I want from this employee table. So I need the department column. I would also need the average salary, so I'll use the aggregate function avg and then pass in the column which is eSalary, and I will name this column as average salary. Now I would want this from the employee table, so I'll use the from keyword and then give the name of the table which is employee. After this, I'll give the group by keyword to group this table with respect to the department column. So I will give in the name of the column which is edept. Now, before I go ahead and use the having clause, let me actually execute just these three lines of code. Right. So what I've basically done is I have grouped this employee table with respect to the department column and we have the average salary with respect to each of these departments. Right. So this is the average salary of analytics department, average salary of operations department and average salary of sales and support. Now, I will use the having clause to display only those records where the average salary is greater than $100,000. So the average salary needs to be greater than $100,000. Now I'll select all of this, I'll hit execute. Right, so we see that out of the four departments, only operations and sales department have the average salary of the employees to be greater than $100,000. So the average salary of employees in operations department is $103,000. And the average salary in the sales department is $159,000. This is how we can work with the having clause in SQL. And this brings us to the end of this session. Thanks for attending and let's meet in the next class.